We're coming to the last stages of completing the commissioning of all the instrumentation on the digester. That's the 4,000 cubic meter or 4 million liter digester with the dome fully inflated. All the pumps, the gas treatment equipment, silver pipes in the front are the hot water coming in to heat the digester. That's the pump room over there. Over here we have the blower that keeps the dome inflated. This is where the digestate is fed into the digester. The hot and cold water. The valve that allows the water to be circulated. These are the heating coils connected to the inside of the digester. All the blue cable is the cable connecting our instrumentation to the piglet. Here we have the two of the three eventual blowers that boosts the gas to the boiler room. The blue machine in the distance is the compressor that boosts the gas that we use for mixing the digester. Our instrumentation includes a temperature sensor here to measure the temperature of the hot water that comes, or the heated medium that comes out, to see how much heat transfer has occurred into the sludge. The other blue cable is for the electric circulation valve, cable trays. That instrument is to measure the temperature of the sludge inside. It's a probe that sticks a meter and a half into the digestate. That instrument there is a pH sensor. We go all the way to the top of the digester. It's this radar level sensor, so we can see how full or how empty the digester is. And this stainless steel panel here, we've got pH indicator and a level sensor that tells us how full the digester is. This all communicates via cable to the piglet that's situated over here. Other work that the piglet does via those two cables going that side is another temperature sensor on the other side of the digester, as well as a pressure sensor that we can use to measure the level of the digester. And the relays from the piglet also speaks to pneumatic valves coils that's situated inside that box over there, and that activates these valves over here. As you can see, there's numbers against the back of the manhole, so there's a sequence. The piglet opens the valve, and as soon as the valve opens, it forms a pressure drop which activates that compressor that sends the compressed biogas in through whichever valve is open to facilitate the mixing within the digester. All this is done through the little piglet over here that for this application is basically just a remote terminal unit. It's got enough processing power to run the digester on its own, but because we cannot change parameters on the piglet, we've made it in such a way that it speaks to the warthog, which is situated inside the pump room. And the antenna you can see retreating there, that is the method of communication. So there's no cable between the two units, it's only via radio. This antenna here is the communication between the piglet and the warthog. The warthog is situated inside the pump room on top of the MCC. And here's a whole lot of cables here for instruments such as this temperature sensor. This is the heated medium, the temperature into the digesters. And then all those cables, there's a pressure sensor for the gas at the other end there, and also to the compressor over here. We are now inside the pump room. This is the warthog. As you can see, at the moment it purely serves as a display because we're busy still commissioning some of the instrumentation. Now, a lot of the readouts that you see here is transmitted by radio from the piglet to the antenna you've seen outside. The plugs on the left hand side of the Warthog, those are the digital outputs or relays or on and off switches. And on this side is all instrumentation. This includes flow meters, level sensors, as well as the gas pressure, which is connected to VSDs running the blower pumps. This is some of the equipment that's managed by the Warthog. Over there is our circulation and macerator pumps. And the pump over there is the feed pump. And this setup here is a recirculation pump where some of the effluent out of the digester is recirculated back into the mixing dam to help boost the bacterial growth. This dam over here receives the effluent from the overflow of the digester. From here the farmer will extract the digester to become fertilizer on the carrot farm. And also, as said earlier, we will recirculate some of the digestate from there into the mixing dam, which is situated over here. This is the mixing dam, situated behind the pump room, with the digester over there and the effluent dam over there. So this ramp here is where trucks would introduce silage and chicken waste into the mixing dam. And that pipe over there brings the carrot pulp in all the way from the juicing plant, which is over there. Along those pipes. Then gas is pumped back to a boiler room, which is right in the middle over there. Looks like a double garage. The boiler room supplies the steam for the juicing plant. The excess steam, or the excess thermal energy, is pumped back through the silver insulated pipes into heat the digester over there. Digestate, effluent into the effluent dam, becomes fertilizer. So that's a nice complete circle.